Good evening. Hello, Cecilia.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, Melvin. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm still working.
Really?
Yes, and I'm disconnected for an hour.
Oh, my God. What time do you finish?
I don't know. I hope. So. I don't know. 1 hour more, I think.
And do you drive?
Yes. Yes, and tomorrow I have to go to my office to...
Oh, so right now you're in your house?
Yes, I'm at home. Yes.
But working?
Yes.
All right. Okay, well, someone has to do it.
Sorry?
Someone has to do it.
Yes, definitely.
Yep. And that someone, it's you.
Yes.
All right. Cecilia, can you hear me?
Yes.
How are you today?
I'm worried. Worried.
Why are you worried?
Working.
Okay. Are you in your house?
Yes.
But you're working?
Yes.
Okay, good. Nelly, can you hear me?
Yes, and you?
Oh, I can hear you perfectly. How was your day?
Boring, so boring.
In your house?
Yeah.
Okay, but I imagine that you are resting.
Yes, I'm doing math. Because we have to see cómo agarrar dinero.
How to make money.
How to get money. How to make money.
Okay. All right.
I'm doing math.
Excuse me?
I am doing mask.
You're wearing a mask.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Wearing.
How many people in your house?
Just me.
Only you?
Yes.
Okay. Are you wearing gloves?
No.
Only the mask?
Yes.
I wear a mask and gloves if I go outside. Like today, I had to go to the supermarket because we needed some things. So, you know, so I wore long sleeve, a mask, and gloves.
Just to go out.
Just to go out, and a lot of sanitizer.
Yeah.
Teacher, yep. And it was crowded at the supermarket.
Not really. There is a line because the access is very limited. They let go like 10 people at a time, groups of 10, groups of 10. Yeah. So the line that you make is only to go in, but when you are in the supermarket, it is not bad. It is not full. It's not crowded.
But you have to buy quickly, I guess.
That's the best idea. I mean, like, do your shopping quickly and you try to leave as quickly as possible because you don't want to be exposing yourself to the air or to other people.
And you have a list?
I have a list. Yep. And only one person. Well, you have to go alone.
Yes.
No company. Okay. So this week we have topics that are very, very important. So my suggestion is don't miss classes except if it's really necessary. Every class is important, but this week we will be working with the simple past tense. And that is one of the tenses that people use a lot in English. So you have to be familiar with the simple past tense as well. Okay, so let's begin today's class. Do you remember the topics that we cover on Thursday?
Places?
Places, exactly. Can you give me examples of places?
Like the supermarket and the pharmacy.
Okay, the supermarket, the market.
Pharmacy or drugstore.
Very good. The pharmacy or drugstore. They are synonyms.
Restaurants.
Gas station. Exactly. So
bank.
A bank, right. So where can I go to send a package? What's the name of the place? I want to send a package. Where do I have to go?
Post office.
Yes, the post office. What if I want to buy medicine?
In the drugstore.
Drugstore. What is a synonym of drugstore?
Pharmacy.
Very good. How do you say receta médica in English?
Prescription.
Very good. Prescription. And how do you say receta de cocina?
Recipe,
very good. So recipe is for food, prescription is for medicine. Okay, and what is the name of the quiet place where I can study? A public quiet place where I can study. What's the name in Spanish?
Librería.
Biblioteca.
No. Biblioteca. How do you say biblioteca? Okay.
Library.
Yes. So library is not librería. Library is biblioteca. Yeah, so be careful. Because the names are very similar. If you compare librería and library, they are very similar, but the meaning is different. Yep. Now,
okay.
Where can I pay a mortgage? Where can I pay a mortgage? Where can I pay a mortgage?
What does it mean, mortgage?
Very good. Eso es lo que espero. Si no logra entender la palabra, pregunte, que para eso es la clase.
What's the meaning of mortgage?
Okay, right now. I'm going to put it in the WhatsApp chat. Mortgage. Almita says, in a bank. Mortgage is the money that you pay every month for your house to the bank. The like,
what's the meaning in Spanish?
A rent? No.
Okay, listen carefully. El dinero se lo estoy dando al banco todos los meses por mi casa, al banco. Mortgage. ¿Alguien lo dijo?
¿Hipoteca?
Hipoteca, exactly. Hipoteca. Mortgage. So, one more time. Where can I pay a mortgage?
In the bank.
Very good. Where can I cash a check?
In In the bank.
In the bank.
Cuando digo cash a check, ¿qué digo ahí?
Cambiar un cheque.
Cobrar,
cobrar el cheque.
Correcto. Cobrarlo o cambiarlo. Pero muchas veces pensamos que la palabra es change, lo cual existe. Pero si usted le va a decir a alguien, I want to change my check, es porque el cheque tiene algo malo y usted no lo puede cambiar. ¿Me explico? Es decir, si digamos le pusieron 200 en vez de 2,000, usted llega donde el patrón y le dice, I want to change my check. Ahí se aplica porque está pidiendo que le hagan una sustitución de ese cheque. ¿Me explico?
Yes.
So, si usted lo que quiere es recibir el dinero en el banco, usted va a decir cash a check. ¿Se han fijado que muchas veces antes de entrar al banco, el seguridad le pregunta qué es la, cuál es la transacción?
Yes.
So, if they ask you in Miami or in Chicago, you will say, I want to cash a check. I want to cash a check. Okay, any questions? Questions about Thursday? No. Les vuelvo a repetir, para los que no se habían conectado, esta semana vamos a empezar a ver el pasado simple, uno de los 12 tiempos gramaticales que es de suma importancia a la hora de hablar inglés. O ya solo nos quedan un par de clasecitas, así que haga el esfuerzo para no desaparecerse. So anyways, we go here. Let me share this here. Prepositions map right here. Okay, do you see the image?
No. No, yes.
Yes.
Okay.
It's not very small.
Okay, what about now?
This is small.
Can you see it now?
Yes. 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 It's very good. Yes.
Okay, very good. All right. Now, last week, we were talking about places. Pero para usted escribir dónde está ubicado un lugar, you need prepositions. So, can you mention, yes, can you mention examples of places in your neighborhood?
Place.
A store.
Okay, a store. Me lo acaban de decir hace unos minutos. A bank, a restaurant, a supermarket. Police station.
Pharmacy.
A pharmacy.
Gas station.
Cinema.
A cinema.
How do we say sorbetería?
Ice cream shop.
Ice cream shop.
Like La Nevería, Eskimo, Pops, and all that. Okay. So look at the prepositions that we have here. How many images do you see? How many prepositions do you see?
Four, five.
Five.
Five. Okay, the first five. One is on.
On.
On the corner of.
On the corner of.
Acuérdese que esa OF suena como OV.
OV.
Si lleva doble F. Si lleva doble F, entonces usted dice, let me put it here for you. Oh, se lo vamos a escribir acá.
Oh.
Oh. Where is this?
On the corner.
Okay, so ahí lo tenemos. Because many times we think that one F and double F is the same, but it's not. English is different. So if he has one F, you say of.
Oh.
Of. Así como usted en el chat de WhatsApp. In the corner of.
On the corner of.
On the corner of.
Yes. Now, if the word has double F, then you say off.
Off.
So, how do you pronounce the second preposition?
On the corner of.
The corner of.
Very good, on the corner of. What about number three?
Across from.
Across from. Number four?
Next to.
And the last one is?
Between.
Between. Very good. Now, what's the meaning of on? The department store is on Main Street.
Main Street.
¿Qué dice ahí? The department store is on Main Street.
La tienda de departamental está en la calle.
En la calle principal.
Está sobre la calle principal.
Sobre. On Main Street.
Sobre. Now, look at number two. On the corner of. It's on the corner of Main and First. ¿Qué dice ahí?
It's on the corner.
Está en la esquina de la primera y la primera.
En la esquina de Main y First.
Sobre.
Entonces, si yo le digo, fíjese que la gasolinera está en la esquina de Constitución y Prolongación Juan Pablo. Yo voy a decir, the gas station is on the corner of Constitution Boulevard en Prolongación Juan Pablo. Ya se ubicaron cuál gasolinera les digo, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Across from. It's across from the park. ¿Qué dice ahí?
Cruzar el parque.
Al cruzar. Al cruzar. Al cruzar. So, ¿cómo me va a decir al cruzar Simán?
It's
across from the Simán.
Exactly. It's across from Simán. Now we have next to. What is next to?
It's next to the bank.
A la par de.
A la par de, contiguo a, next to. And then you próximo. Have between, ajá, próximo también, exacto. And between, the bank is between the department store and the restaurant.
Banco está
en
medio de.
Ajá, en medio de o entre.
O entre.
Ajá, exactly. Exactly. All right. Any questions about this?
No. No question.
No.
Is everything clear?
Clear.
Okay. Do you know where Cathedral is? ¿Dónde está Catedral? ¿Cuáles son esas dos calles que se unen? Avenida Cuscatlán, ¿y cuál? ¿Cómo se llama aquel edificio que se cayó en el 86?
Rubén Darío.
Darío.
Exactly, calle Rubén Darío. So you say Cathedral is on the corner of calle Rubén Darío en Avenida Cuscatlán. Right? ¿Qué tan buenos son para las direcciones? Are you good? You're bad?
No.
I am bad.
Okay.
only reference.
Okay. Do you remember ex Hospital Maternidad?
Yes.
What is the name of the intersection there? Are you from El Salvador?
I don't know.
25th Avenue.
Yes.
And Primera.
The first
Avenue.
Yes.
First Street.
First Street.
Yeah, 25 yeah. Avenida y la primera calle. Yes. All right. Anyways, any questions about prepositions here?
Next to, across from the bank. It's next to the bank. It's next to.
Are we okay?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Déjenme, le voy a enviar esta imagen. Para que usted describa lugares en su vecindario o cerca de donde trabaja. Obviamente usted sabe muy bien dónde está ubicado todo. So ahorita que los ponga a trabajar en parejas, usted le dice, in my neighborhood, the park is next to my house. In my neighborhood, Banco Agrícola is between Super Selectos and Don Pollo. In my neighborhood, the police station is on the corner of Main Street and Desvío a Zacacoyo, whatever. So you have to practice that. Are you ready? ¿Estamos listos?
Sure, una pregunta.
Yes.
¿Cómo se le dice a los pasajes?
Good
si
question.
Si uno vive así como en condominios.
Yeah, passage. Ahorita se lo escribo.
Okay.
Passage. Porque yo le puedo preguntar a usted, do you live on Main Street or on a passage? ¿Qué le pregunto ahí?
Yeah.
Do you live on Main Street or on a passage?
¿Vivo sobre la calle principal o un pasaje?
Exactly. So ahí decimos passage.
Passage.
Yes, passage.
Passage.
Yep. Are we ready? Entonces, usted le va a dar, yes, le va a dar ubicaciones a su compañero con el que toque trabajar acerca de dónde vive, dónde estudia, dónde trabaja o cualquier otra ubicación en la cual usted pueda aplicar esto. Are we ready?
Ready.
Yes.
Here we go. Give me a second. Breakout rooms. We got 9 people, 4 groups. Let's go. Hello, hello.
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 How are you today?
I'm fine.
Good, very good.
And you?
I'm okay. Mr. Diaz, what's your first name?
Julio.
Julio. Okay, Julio, you're going to work with Geraldine. You're actually going to work with Geraldine.
Actually, no work.
No, listen. You're going to work with Geraldine. Geraldine is your partner. Con Geraldine va a trabajar ahorita usted.
Okay, okay.
All right, good. Bye bye.
Bank?
No, in a DLC. Gas station brand.
Is a Super Selectos market and park municipal. Creo que está bien así, ¿verdad?
What was the sentence?
Excuse me.
¿Cuál fue la oración que le dio?
Ah, que mi vecindario está cerca del Super Selectos y el parque municipal.
Okay, one more time. My house.
My house is
near
me trabé.
Pamela, help him.
In my neighborhood, my house is near to the, no recuerdo cómo se dice, alcaldía.
City Hall.
City Hall.
Okay. City Hall. Okay, good. Okay, so Eric, one more time. Dígame cualquier oración.
In my neighborhood is my house street. ¿Cómo se dice calle principal? Main Street of the park.
Okay. ¿Su casa está en la calle principal?
Por el parque, quizás.
Okay, okay. So my house is on Main Street near the park.
Near the park.
Okay, so my house is on Main Street near the park.
Okay.
Okay, repeat.
In my house
is on Main Street.
Is on Main Street
near the park.
Near the park.
Excellent.
Olímpica.
Hello, hello.
No, sir.
Did you finish practicing?
Yes.
Any questions about the prepositions? Hay más preposiciones. This is only the introduction.
For example, teacher, is a preposition near to?
Yes, near.
Okay, near.
Solamente near, no le ponga to.
Okay.
Near the hospital, near my house, near the park.
In the opposite far, to is the preposition.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, now in that case you say far from my house, far from my office.
From, okay.
Yes. All right, behind? How do you, what is it? Behind. Behind, that's a preposition too. ¿Cómo me va a decir el parque está atrás del banco?
The park is behind the bank.
Yeah, the park is behind the bank. Exactly. Any questions? No? Okay, so let's continue with the same topic but with a different activity. And it's this one here. Do you see the image?
Yes.
Okay, what do you see in the picture?
A family?
A family, maybe. Where are they? Where
the
are
corner.
They? Uh-huh,
the
good.
Is between in the mom and father.
Okay, very good. La respuesta que me dieron anterior también está buena. Cuando le digo, where are they? Alguien dijo, in the corner of a street. En la esquina de una calle. That is correct. How many people in the picture?
Three people.
Three people.
How many kids?
One.
How
one.
Many women?
One woman.
How many men?
One man.
Okay, so do you think this is a family?
No.
No.
It looks like no. A family, but they're not. Okay. Can you give me a description about what the man is wearing? What is he wearing?
He's wearing a shirt.
Shirt.
A with a pants.
Gray pants.
Gray or brown? I don't know.
Brown, pants.
Okay, brown pants. And what color is the shirt?
Yellow.
Yeah, yellowish. What about the little boy? What is he wearing?
An overall.
Yes, an overall.
Yes. Did you use overalls when you were a kid?
Yes.
Yes.
I did. I have pictures with overall. Those pictures are compromising. Francisco in overalls. And what about the lady? What is she wearing?
Mm, A long sleeve shirt.
I think it's a long sleeve shirt.
Very good. Yeah, a sweater, a long sleeve shirt.
Long hair.
Long hair or short hair?
Long hair.
Long hair.
Okay, slim or heavy?
Slim.
Slim. Okay, so let's check. What's the name of the conversation?
It's across from the park.
It's across from the park. Está al cruzar el parque. So how many people in the conversation?
Two people.
We have a man and we have a woman. I'm going to read the conversation one time. You pay attention for pronunciation. And if you have questions about meaning, you let me know. Here we go. Excuse me, can you help me? Is there a public restroom around here? A public restroom? I'm sorry, I don't think so. Oh no, my son needs a restroom. Well, there is a restroom in the department store on Main Street. Where on Main Street? It's on the corner of Main and First Avenue. On the corner of Main and First? Yes, it's across from the park. You can't miss it. Thanks a lot. Any questions about vocabulary or pronunciation?
What mean is department store?
An example of a department store, Simon, Sears,
okay.
Sanborns.
Como tienda grande.
Yeah. Yeah, different departments.
Department store. Department store.
Do you see the expression in the little kid? Do you see the expression on his face?
Yeah. Worried.
Worried, exactly. He's worried. Está preocupado, chiquillo. Ya no aguanta. Yep. Okay, any questions about the vocabulary? No?
No.
You can't miss it. Es una expresión altamente importante. ¿Qué significa?
No se puede perder.
Exactly, no se puede perder. La, usted dice eso cuando las instrucciones están súper claras.
Claras.
You can't miss it. No se puede perder.
No se puede perder.
Ajá. You can't miss it. Como que ande buscando X lugar y el edificio sea bien peculiar y aparte eso tiene un gran rótulo, le van a decir, you can't miss it. Any questions? Okay, so you have a restaurant, you have a department store. What's the name of this? What's the name of this color green?
Trees,
yes. What is this?
Street.
What is this?
Corner.
Okay, but the space where people walk?
Inside.
Sidewalk.
Okay, the street is for cars.
Sidewalk.
Yes, and the sidewalk is for people.
La acera.
Yes, sidewalk. Sidewalk. What is this here? Color blue.
The sky.
The sky, and this color white?
Is.
How do you say nubes in English? Clouds, exactly, clouds. Yes. So we have the street, we have the sidewalk, we have a restaurant, we have a store, we have trees, sky, and clouds. Any questions?
No.
No? Okay, so I need two volunteers. I need a man and a woman.
Me? Only,
okay, man. Maria Luisa, you are the man if you want, yes. And the other one? Okay, Pamela, thank you very much. So Maria and Pamela, 1, 2, 3, go.
Okay, excuse me, can you help me? Is there a public restroom around here?
A public restroom? I'm sorry, I don't think so.
Oh no, my son needs a restroom.
Well, there's a restroom in the department store on Main Street.
Where on Main Street?
It's on the corner of Main and First Avenue.
Oh, the corner of Main and First?
Yes, it's across from the park. You can't miss it.
Thank you a lot.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Very good. All right, any questions about pronunciation or meaning of the words?
Restroom, restroom?
Yeah, restroom.
Restroom.
Restroom. Yes.
Okay.
Does restroom. Anybody know the difference between the restroom and the bathroom?
Restroom.
Hay una diferencia, restroom. Pero en la vida real, usted anda buscando un inodoro, usted puede decir restroom y bathroom y le van a entender, pero aunque en la realidad son diferentes. What's the difference?
The restroom don't have a shower.
Exactly. The restroom doesn't have a shower. Cuando usted va a un restaurante y pide prestado el sanitario, no espera encontrar una ducha ahí, sino que es solo lo sanitario.
Restroom.
El de su casa sí es bathroom.
Okay.
Y la misma palabra lo dice, bathroom, que también se puede bañar. All right, any questions here? Questions, no. Questions? Okay.
Yes. Yes.
So let's do yes. Some of these. Check this here. Do you see the image?
No.
Yes.
What's the name of the image?
Fifth Avenue.
Exactly, Fifth Avenue. Now, can you tell me what is the situation right now in New York?
It's an infected place.
Yes, exactly. New York?
An infected place.
Yeah. It's really bad. I mean,
yes.
It's really serious.
But it's for, I don't know, the squirrel?
Yeah, careless.
It's for careless, pure careless.
Yeah,
careless.
Exactly, exactly. So I read information, I don't know if it's true, pero decían que ayer ya habían 400 muertos en Estados Unidos, no sé si era cierto. Last night, ayer en la noche, hoy en la madrugada, no me acuerdo, but I don't know if it's true. Anyways, so this information is about New York. Here in the article, they mention four different destinies, four different destinies. Do you recognize the first picture?
Empire State.
Aha, the Empire State. Okay, I need a volunteer to read the information about this, the Empire State Building.
Okay.
Yes, Mr. Julius Diaz, please.
Yes. Okay, start your tour at the Empire State Building on Fifth Avenue between 33rd and 34th Street.
Uh-huh.
This building has 102 floors. Take the elevator to the 102.
102nd.
102nd. a floor for a great view of New York City.
Okay, good. Any questions about vocabulary or pronunciation?
No.
No.
Okay, I need another volunteer to read number two.
I can do.
Yes, please, Pamela.
Number two. Now walk up Fifth Avenue, 7 blocks to the New York Public Library. The entrance is between 40th and 42nd Streets. This library holds over 10 million books. Behind the library is Bryant Park. In the summer, there's an outdoor cafe, and at lunch hour, there are free music concerts.
Thank you. Any questions about the New York Public Library?
No.
No.
Okay. Another volunteer for number three. Yes. Only one. Okay, Melvin, thank you.
Number three. Walk up 6th Avenue to 49th Street. You're standing in the middle of the 19th building of Rockefeller Center. Turn right of 49th Street, walk another block, and turn left. You're in Rockefeller Plaza. In the winter, you can
ice skate
in the ring there.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Questions about vocabulary or pronunciation?
What does it mean, ring, teacher?
Ring is pista de hielo. Other questions? Ahí le están dando instrucciones cómo llegar a X lugar, cruzar aquí, está a la derecha, a la izquierda, and so on. Any questions on part three?
No. No.
All right. And the last one, number four, please. Only one. All right, please, thank you.
Number four, drive across from Rockefeller Center. On Fifth Avenue is St. Patrick's Cathedral. It's modeled after the cathedral in Cologne, Germany. Coincide St. Patrick's and Lille.
Noisy
city behind, look at the beautiful blue window. Many of these windows come from France.
All right. Any questions there?
What is modeled?
El modelo fue copiado de la Catedral de Colón en Alemania.
Okay.
Es decir, el diseño fue copiado de la, el diseño lo agarraron de la catedral que está en Colón, Alemania. Una réplica.
Ajá.
Anything else? Any questions? No. Have you ever visited Iglesia El Calvario in San Salvador?
Church, yes. Calvary in San Salvador.
Okay, but have you visited that church before?
Yes.
It's a very nice church.
Never.
It's a very nice church. Mire, ya estando dentro va a pensar que está en Europa.
Es la de los vitrales, ¿verdad, teacher?
Y...
No, that's el rosario.
Ah. Sí, el rosario es otra, pero esta que tiene un estilo bien gótico es esta, la del Calvario, la que está enfrente del Mercado Central.
Sagrado Corazón.
Exactly, in front of Sagrado Corazón.
Que tiene como los picos. ¿Sí?
Uh-huh. Ya, es como color negro grisoso. Uh-huh. Sí. Yep. It's a very nice place. Yeah. Really nice. Y no hay necesidad de profesar la religión, sino que para entrar a admirar la arquitectura que hay adentro. It's really beautiful. It's really nice. All right. Any questions there about the four destinies in New York?
No.
Irónicamente, esos cuatro lugares ahorita están desiertos. Deserted. Deserted.
Deserted.
Yeah, deserted. All right. Any questions about the reading?
No.
No? Okay. So let's change topic. Ahorita vamos a algo que le va a servir para el resto de su vida. Todo, todo. How do you say no traje mi mochila?
No grab my
no bag. Traje. Es tiempo pasado. No traje.
I don't.
Ok, remember this. Vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso acá. What's the auxiliary that I use for simple present tense? Pregúnteme si tengo hijos.
I didn't.
Pregúnteme si tengo hijos.
Do you have children?
Ok, very good. Do you have children? Pregúnteme si mi hermana tiene hijos.
Your
sister
have children.
Does your sister have
children?
Okay, remember this. ¿Se acuerdan del do y el does?
Yes.
Okay, what's the function of do and does? We use do and does to make questions in present. Do you like chocolate? Do you have a car? Do you work on Saturdays? Does your father live in San Salvador? Does your sister have children? Todas esas preguntas que acabo de hacer son en presente simple y para hacer la pregunta tengo que ocupar do and does. That's the auxiliary we use. If I want to make questions in past tense, I need to use did.
Did.
Pregúnteme si leí el periódico hoy.
Did you read the paper today?
Very good. Did you read the newspaper today?
Did you read the newspaper today?
Ajá. Pregúnteme si dormí bien.
Did you sleep well today?
Very good. Did you sleep well? Usted se levanta a las 5 de la mañana y a la primera persona que ve en su casa, usted le pregunta, did you sleep well? ¿Dormiste bien?
Did you sleep well?
Ajá. ¿Cómo le va a preguntar a alguien, te tomaste la medicina?
Did you take your medicine?
Uh-huh. Did you take your medicine? Digamos, usted llega a su casa y mira distinto a su esposo o a su esposa y le dice, te cortaste el pelo.
Did you cut the hair?
Did you cut your hair? Yes. So, como manera de repaso, para hacer preguntas en tiempo pasado, yo voy a ocupar did.
Did.
La forma del verbo siempre se va a quedar en su forma natural o en su forma base, por decir así. Did you cut your hair? Did you take your vitamin? Did you read the newspaper? Did you go to your office? What if the information is negative? How do you say no te envié el reporte?
I didn't send you the report.
Yes, I didn't send you the report. I didn't send you the report. How do you say no traje la mochila?
I didn't bring the backpack.
Good. I didn't bring the backpack. Como usted puede ver, cómo empieza a jugar un papel importante su vocabulario. Porque la estructura del pasado simple es bastante fácil de digerirla, pero para eso necesita, you need vocabulary.
So, in negative sentences, we use the verb,
Okay, you use auxiliary didn't, and the form of the verb is base form.
Okay.
Para hacer el negativo, usted lo ocupa didn't y el verbo siempre se vuelve a quedar en su forma base. ¿Cómo me va a decir no usé alcohol gel?
I didn't use sanitizer.
Very good. Sanitizer. I didn't use sanitizer. Very good. How do you say no te vi en la iglesia?
I didn't see you in the church.
Good. In the church.
You can say in or you can say at. The two options are good. I didn't see you in church. I didn't see you at church.
At church.
Yes. At. How do you say hoy no trabajé?
I didn't work today.
What usted ya va a medio camino y se da cuenta que el teléfono ya se le va a apagar y usted dice, no cargué el teléfono.
I didn't charge my phone.
Very good. I didn't charge my phone. Algunos de ustedes ya tienen el teléfono programado en inglés y el simple hecho de conectarlo, automáticamente le aparece ahí charging.
Charging.
Y de esa manera, de tanto estar viendo usted la palabra charging, 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 que se le queda sin necesidad de repetir ni nada. Pero para eso usted se tiene que exponer al inglés lo más posible. Right?
Right.
Okay. Any questions about the negatives? Y aquí va la pregunta del millón. When the information is positive, what is the form of the verb in simple past? Todo esto que estamos platicando se lo voy a mandar de manera escrita el día de mañana. Ahorita solo estamos haciendo un brainstorm para brainstorm, una tormenta de ideas. What happens? Ya dijimos cómo se hace el negativo y cómo se hace la pregunta. Now the question is, how do you make positive sentences? Como es positivo, usted solamente va a ocupar el verbo en su forma pasada. Exactly. How do you say quebrar in English?
Break.
Break. Break. What is the past tense of break?
Broke.
How do you say quebré el teléfono?
I broke my cell phone.
Exactly. How do you say fui al parque?
I went to the park.
Si usted me dice I go to the park, ahí lo que me está diciendo, yo ir al parque. La gente le entiende, but it's not good. It's similar when a gringo is talking with you. Usted le dice yo ir a la playa. Usted le entiende, pero sabe que está dicho malo. Yo comprar un carro. Está mal dicho, pero usted le entiende. Pero aquí no solo se trata de comunicarnos, sino que comunicarnos bien. So, when the information is positive, the form of the verb is in past.
Me aburro soberanamente.
The form of the verb is in past form.
Past
El verbo va a ir en su forma pasada. How do you say enviar in English?
Send.
Send. And what is the past tense of send?
Send.
Send.
Send. Send.
Many times, the only difference between present and past is only one letter. Por ejemplo, el verbo enviar. En presente termina en D, en pasado termina en una T. So how do you say te envié la información?
I sent you the information.
No fueron suficientes.
I sent you the information. Exactly. What is the past tense of read?
Read.
Read.
Read. Read. El tiempo pasado de leer se escribe igual, but pronunciation is different. So the past tense of read is read. How do you say leí todo el libro?
I have read all book.
I read all the book. I read all the book. Okay. So ahorita que la mayoría de nosotros tenemos tiempo en nuestras manos, quizás no todos, pero la mayoría, lea para mañana todo lo que usted pueda sobre el pasado simple. Si hay algo que usted no lo entiende, anótelo y me lo pregunta mañana. Mañana entramos de lleno con el pasado simple. Do you have any questions about today?
No.
No,
no questions. Okay, so if you don't have any questions, we continue tomorrow, same place, same time. Thank you for your time and have a good night.
Bye. See you tomorrow, teacher.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you later.
Bye. See you later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.